great would it be to have a free resource that allows you to scan your WordPress website, page, or post, and identify some of the accessibility errors or warnings that you may need to address to make your WordPress website more accessible? Hi, and welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton, and we're looking at accessibility for WordPress. Now, I've got a free resource for you today. Equalize Digital has put together a plugin that allows you to add it to your WordPress website, and it will deliver an audit report for you so that you can start being proactive in making your website more accessible. Now, the version we're going to review today is totally free. I'll show you the benefits, though, of upgrading to Pro if you stick around toward the end of this video. Let me show you how to add it to your WordPress website and get started improving the accessibility on your WordPress website today. Let's get started with how to install the free version. Let's log into your WordPress website and head over into your dashboard. Go ahead and click on Plugins and Add New. And here we're going to do a search for Equalize Digital. They offer two different free plugins. The one we're interested in is this first one right here that says Accessibility Checker. This is going to help us identify the accessibility errors on our website. So we're going to click Install Now, and we will click Activate. Okay, now that that's installed, over here on the left side, you'll see that you have Accessibility Checker and our settings. Let's jump into settings. And you'll see the options that you get in this free version. We're able to check posts and pages. If you have different types of custom post types, you may want to go ahead and invest in the pro version of this plugin so that you can do a complete, full, all-at-once site scan and be certain to scan additional custom post types. You'll see all sorts of different options that you can get if you upgrade to this pro version. But for now, in this tutorial, we'll stay focused on this free version. You can adjust some additional settings here if you would like to have a simplified summary, if you would like to have the summary positioned before the content or after. You can also add in an accessibility statement in the footer, or if you have your own policy, you can link to that as well by adding in your own URL. For now, we're just going to leave everything as default and click Save Changes. If you are running the pro version of this, you can actually perform an entire site scan all at once. On the free version, we have to go through page by page, post by post. But that's all right. We're going to jump into our home page. I clicked on Edit to see my edit screen here. Now, I'm not going to make any changes. My first step is to actually just click Update. We're going to basically save this page as it is. And that's going to activate the plugin to start the audit on this specific page. Now watch this, I'm gonna scroll all the way down to the bottom and check out just below my content, I get to see the audit findings for this individual page. I've not made any adjustments yet, right? I've just clicked that update button. But I get to see right away that they've already spotted 12 errors, 11 warnings. And if I were to click on details here, I could see what those are. I could open them up for more information. They even have a little information icon here. If I were to click on that, it takes me over to a full, complete understanding of what error or issue they're describing to me. And you can work through each one of these in this sense. You also have a readability tab here as well that gives you further clarity on the overall reading level. There's another view though that I find a little bit more helpful, and that's the front side of the website. So let's go take a look at the homepage on the front side over here. And everything looks the same except for this little icon living right down here in the bottom right corner. If I were to click on that now, because I've already clicked update, it shows me those 12 errors and 11 warnings right here. And as I scroll down the page, you can see the icons hovering over the sections called into question. So if I were to click on one of those icons, this right side opens up with a full description of the issue, allowing me to see that this little image right here is missing its alt text. Or perhaps this is an incorrect heading error. And it gives me, again, full clarity on what they're calling out as a concern or an issue or an error. As you work through these things and address each one, you can click update on your page and work through each one to hopefully perfect and polish the page and remove these errors or issues.
Let's go take a look at changing some of those alt tags and see what the results look like.
Now, you can either do this from your media library, where you can choose the image that might be missing its alt tag and add it right in, or you can do it directly on the page. Depending upon the theme that you're using, you should be able to click on the image and see an alt text area where you can add in alternative text behind every image. If you're curious to know how to improve that or what to really put there, you can certainly click on the link just below that will take you over to a great tutorial giving you more insight on best practices when it comes to alternate text. But typically what you want to do there is just put a true description of what the image is, like person wearing yellow coat in winter. Now that we've made a few adjustments to some of these alt tags, let's click update, and that will allow the plugin to scan the page again. And let's go back to the front side of the website and take a look at our results. We just want to click on the icon here that will allow it to pull up the report. And there you go. You see that we only have 10 errors and 10 warnings. So obviously it's a process as you work through these things one by one, but you do get to see the results right away, which is very helpful for you to improve your process. So when you're ready to upgrade to that pro version, you can access it right here in your own dashboard or visit their website. And you're going to be able to do an entire website scan all at one time, y'all. So this is askkori.com. I'm really sad to say this is my score right now. I was able to do a full accessibility check on it, a full scan, and you can see 1,600 unique errors. I mean, I've got a lot of warnings going on. This is partly due to the theme I'm using. This is partly due to just laziness in my own development, but this is certainly something that you would want to do as you work through the site. You get to also have an open issues log that just really easily sums up what's working well, what's not working well, and allows you to kind of view these things in a little bit more of a bulk view. So if I wanted to come in here, I could click on the view icon. It would take me over to the page itself. And of course, it's going to help me identify the fact that my kind of orange text for my links just doesn't have enough contrast on the page up against a white background. So it's really telling me that I might be able to change and fix a lot of errors seen throughout the entire website just by going into my color palette and making a more impactful, a more contrasting color choice here on my links, maybe even adding a visual line underneath the link so that people can visually see that it's available to be clicked on. You also have the ability to fast track things. You can go here kind of in that bulk approach to things, and you can either globally ignore things or view them really quickly so that you can see, okay, where does this error actually occur on my website, and try to go in and make those changes a little bit more expedited. You have the ability to set up automated scans as well. So you can have it scan weekly or monthly and have a log here. So if you're interested in truly providing an accessible website for your audience, please consider upgrading to that pro version, reach out to Equalize Digital and get support from them. They can help you even further optimize your website. I'll see y'all next WordPress Wednesday. Bye everyone.